first one to come.
Well, that's the outside. You need more fiber in your diet, Laverne. Look, I'm telling you, I can grow Milo in any parking lot. You cannot deny my skill. Even when I try not to grow stuff, I grow it.
We got three new family members.
Every creature that you can name living down in the deep dark woods. From the tiniest rabbit, the biggest hog, they're all living like they should. Bucks and does are what we call deer, and their babies are called fawns. Hogs and boars are wild pigs that can eat all day long.
Spiders that have eight long arms, snakes and worms with none. They each have their own special charm, can't wait to name each and every one.
Singing, here we go, let's get to know all of the forest animals. Everybody say, gang, that's the name of all the tasty animals. And every creature that I see has a backstrap waiting just for me. So let's have all the forest animals.
Ooh, yeah.
Forest animals.
Oh, you need scissors?
You know, I don't think they'll fly away if these aren't flying away.
Oh, look. Oh, these have more white on them.
They definitely have more white on these.
How am I gonna know what those look again?
Y'all look old.
No, yours has light yellow feathers. Greenies? This one has
that one,
long
that one,
neck.
And that one are.
That one has the long neck.
And they have
neck.
Long necks.
Really
yeah. Look, Dad, that one over there looks like a duck.
That's a mini turkey.
It's just sneezed, isn't it?
Yeah. I thought it was gonna.
These
work.
Are the new ones, right? These two? These two are the new ones?
No. Fluffy white.
Okay.
And one of them on the front of its chest looks like it got like bit or something. Right.
Look,
there.
We can tell this one apart because it has a
where's
giant,
the black spray
giant
paint?
Red thing. It has a giant, whatever that's called. It's huge.
How's your nose, baby? I would have stopped and got you some ice cream, but I forgot we have some at home anyway.
Let me see. Oh my gosh,
unless they ate it all last night.
Got a crooked nut, huh?
Unless they ate it all last night.
No, there's no way. There's vanilla.
I hardly had any. I had like.
Go eat your couple bites of ice cream.
Yeah, you ate all the marshmallows out of it yesterday. I went to go eat some marshmallows.
Throw a couple over there so the other ones can see it. They're like, oh, big chunks of yellow. Like Cinderella here. Is that all three new ones over there? No, that's one.
No, this is a new one.
So they already mixed. They already switched up games.
Yeah,
no loyalty.
The two, the one sitting on the bucket.
That's why. The biggest insult in Russia
feather.
Is to be called a chicken. There's no loyalty. That's a big thing. I understand.
Look, this one we can tell because it has the giant red thing.
Oh wait, Dad.
This one's way bigger.
Did he already clip their wings? Because this is one of the new ones right here and the wings are already clipped.
Wait,
is that one
of the new ones?
No, that's Riley. No, I mean, that's their underneath wings are clipped, because this is also a new one. No, that's yours. That's Elvira.
Emma.
This is
Riley, and
this is those are the new ones. They're all white, yeah.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Well, then the one lying down, I guess.
We got new friends.
He said
when it's super hot, they tend not to lay much.
Oh.
So no big deal on that. It's only just started. Started going to rinse themselves anyhow.
Look at how long this neck is.
Yeah, that's a turkey.
Okay, that's mine, because then I can know exactly which one it is.
See,
I have a really hard time.
That's also the one right here.
You definitely have the longest neck.
Telling the rest
right
of them
and,
apart.
Mom, and that one.
That one has a lot of white on it.
Also on the chest, it has
a lot of white chest.
Yeah, mom's is the nicest looking chicken.
No, because on the front, it looks like it got like bed scratched. Look,
from the side,
it looks
nice.
You like the chickens, Wesley?
Oh, she's sucking that thumb.
Who's got that baby? Who's got that baby? Who's got that baby? Where is that baby? Hello, sweet baby. I love my baby. Hey, you and baby. I'm gonna bite you. Hello? Is that interesting? You ready to try? You say the thread? The thread. Well, hello. Hey, can you say something to the camera? Say, Dada? Dada? Dada! Where is Dada? Hello? Oh, no, no, no. We don't want that. Dada? Where is your father? Let me go. No, 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 no. You can't have, you don't need, and would you stop? Hey, hey, stop. Stop it. That stupid can is going to cut your finger. She's mad. Are you happy? You're so emotional.
You're the most. Oh, you're cold?
Well, hello!
Fussy?
Never. Huh? This child doesn't fuss. Can I have it? You want a bottle, baby? Or, oh, do that here. Come here, baby girl. Let me feed the baby goat.
You know, when you forget to put your camera sideways, it's all for naught. How dare you? Who looks better here? Life is a competition, folks. Where do you stack up amongst the rest, huh? Figure since none of you ladies are ever up in time to know what the hours between 3 and 4 a.m. smell like, I would show you, all of you. Let the dog be upon us. She thinks those horses are after us over there and she wants to go fight them. Pull up / gymnastic bar. It's all the way to here. I smashed it in so we can hang upside down and let our blood flow naturally.
We can hang more clothes on here if we need to.
There you go. That's actually the point. Oh, really? Gotta expand the clothesline because the chicken said we can't use their fence anymore. What do you do on Sunday afternoon? This is a full-size smoker pit like you see at the barbecue cook-off. I'm just that big. Not really. Not even that tall. Barely under, slightly under 8 feet tall. But so, it's Sunday. Did you go to church? We went to church. Yep, we are looking for not just a particular message that speaks truth and life. These fear-based crybaby methods from these pot-bellied gummy bears. I'm telling you, that same tired, rehearsed message of, you know, I really want to live a long time, but I'm okay if I die right now, God. Right? Right? I've said everything right, right? If I died now, I'll go there, right? Please, can you please confirm? Please let me know I'm not wasting my time. I am terrified here. I only believe what people have told me to believe. I have never asked a single question my entire life when it comes to religion. Ever. Because you're trained not to. That's why you're preaching that same tired message that you don't believe. Because understand something, sir. If you have children, I don't care what age they are. They need you around. Life is short. You get that, right? You're not guaranteed tomorrow. You get that, right? So maybe instead of just saying, dear Lord, please help me live a long time because I'm terrified to die because my family needs me around. The truth. Instead of saying the truth. And that confusion leads to inaction. So instead of actually listening to the Bible and doing what it says, preparing, showing appreciation for this life by making it count, helping everyone else. How can you help everyone else when you eat yourself to disability? How can you claim to be a leader of anything if you purposely ate yourself sick? Just because you like that lifestyle so much, you were determined to make it part of yours and get to a point where you wouldn't feel guilty about it anymore. Because now, well, I'm not just fat and lazy. I'm disabled and old. These deliverers of the word. Here is a good comparison. This is what you look out for when you're looking for someone who's delivering a message. There's two types of people that run these churches. From all my vast years of experience, you have leaders, people with a message, people with a sense of purpose, and then you have coordinators. Just sitting here upon my high horse. It's a great view. You should come up here. I would knock you off. Just to lift you up. Sounds like a song. Toby Mac, write it. Send it to me. I'll split the credits with me and my wife. You have enough money. Probably. Anywho. A coordinator is someone who wants to be able to deliver a message. We're going to start talking. You gotta start walking. Coordinators want to be messengers. They are unwillingly, so therefore they are unable to put in that work. The work that it takes to be responsible, to not be overweight, to not be lethargic, to not be so low energy that you never want to do anything ever, ever. The bare minimum just to get by and stick your nose up at everyone else because you think you've got people fooled because you can coordinate beautifully. Everything will flow so smooth. Everything on the outside will appear as it should. It's not okay. It's not okay to be a fake messenger at a church. It's not okay to be a fake leader at your house. Something I heard a long time ago that's resonated deep is the way we do anything is the way we do everything. If you're only doing what you want, it shows in all areas. The cycles are being broken, my friend. Does that explain it? Quick hack to know if you're just coordinating, if you're actually leading. Are you more concerned with how you look on the outside than what's going on in the inside? Are you always trying to take the easy way? I think that's the bottom line.
Are you always looking for the quickest, easiest route? Let's get it here so we can get it over with. I wonder how many creatures out there have actually ever put it together that whatever you put into this life is what you get out of it. You want to lead? You got to do more. More than everyone else. Into your soul until you listen. Watch out for the clotheslines when you're walking. But I know your pain because I've felt lots of pain. And I want to help. I think I figured some things out. It helped me with my pains. This is what God's doing in my life. Let me share something personal. Let me show you some results. We know the difference between a coordinator and a leader. Listen to a preacher get up there and say, you know, why are y'all so afraid? Everyone's in so much fear. You shouldn't fear the devil. He's a loser. He's never won. But the sentence before you said, if you don't know your specific God and your specific pathway, then you're condemned to, what'd you say? An eternal lake of hellfire, right? Okay. Nice words. So let's think about that for just a second. The loser Satan has, out of 7 billion people on this planet, only 1 billion believe the way you believe. And that number seems to be dwindling. Have you looked around at the churches? And what you're also saying is every 70 to 80 years, roughly, Satan increases his flock by about 6 billion. Who's winning? You know, words matter, homie. You can't just repeat stuff that sounds nice, because people that think and people that are listening and people that can smell bull very quickly because they were so full of it for so long. It's a shame that it's considered taboo to ask questions during a sermon. Most of these people don't know what a sermon is. A church that was falling asleep, full of all the potential in the world, but no messenger. Someone fear-based, trying to convince himself of the things he was saying. And constantly begging his audience to not fall asleep. And don't test me at my word, but just accept it. We just different.
He's talking mess. Tell him stop being lazy. Because my wife is getting impatient. You know the temper on that one. She will cook.
with your thumb.
You want to know what being in alignment does for you? This. Because this is all you want. You see, when you're aligned with the Word of God,